Hey everyone, I'm back with some handy mutton from T8T2. So, I have marinated the mutton with yogurt, few dried spices for 1 kg mutton. I have made a paste of onion, ginger garlic paste and raw papaya paste for tenderizing the mutton. Tomato pasted again. So take a deep kadai and put 2 spoons of oil and then heat your mutton to bring that color. Add 1/4 cup oil in a big handi. Add the dried spices and temper them. Then add the onion paste and then fry the onion paste unless it turns lightly brownish in color. Then you can add 1 spoon of ginger garlic paste onto the onion paste and then simmer it along with the onion, and you can also add few green chilies if you like it spicy, and then mix them well and then simmer it in low temperature for around 1-2 minutes before you can add the mutton which was pre-cooked earlier. So you can add the mutton and probably add a little bit of the remaining stock. So handi mutton, it's a dish from Pakistan. Well, our neighborhood has come up with this unique dish which goes well with the taste buds, and you can add this with your parathas and your pulaos. It will just change your entire palate, right? You will just enjoy it. So kabhi kabhi hame apne doston ya fir hame apne neighborhood se bhi thoda bahut khane ka laabza lena chahiye. I know my Hindi is pretty bad. Okay, coming back to the dish. So yeah, it doesn't require a much of stuff. Just few raw spices probably, and that's it. So once you have tempered your onion paste and the ginger garlic paste, you can actually add the pre-cooked mutton, which is slightly brownish in color. This will bring in the richness in the gravy. So I'm just adding the mutton, and you can stir this mutton along with the onion paste and the ginger garlic paste for about 10-12 minutes, and then post that you can add some raw papaya as well, raw papaya paste. So I'm taking like 250 grams of raw papaya paste. This is to tenderize the mutton, and then mix it properly. Once you have mixed this, the mutton starts to tenderize, and then it'll be edible enough. You don't need to actually put it in pressure cooker and for multiple vessels. Papaya does wonders for tenderizing the mutton, and since we are cooking this slowly, papaya is a very essential element here. So one more good thing about mutton, right? The less number of spices or the other things you add on and cook your dish, the more you get the essence of the meat or lamb or whatever it is, and the more you can enjoy the meal. So yeah, I forgot to add bay leaf initially, so I just dropped few bay leaves, pardon me for that, but you can add the bay leaf at the initial stages. Then once your mutton has, you can see the change in color, then you can add the salt as per your taste. So I'm adding like 2 tablespoons of salt, probably 1 teaspoon of haldi, and some red chili powder, again as per your palate, and add some cumin powder or jeera powder, and add, that's again 1 teaspoon of cumin powder and 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. So all this needs to be mixed well, and also you can add a little bit of pepper powder. You can add this at the end as well. I like it a bit spicy, so I'm adding it here. And then start mixing them well. Add a little bit of water and make sure the spices are not burning. And then mix it well. I have just closed my pressure cooker so that it cooks slowly in the dum. And you can see the kind of aroma it will leave, right? It will fill your house with that aroma and you cannot resist your taste buds, okay? You can see the change in color, right? So cooking slowly will definitely bring that richness and texture in the gravy. So what I'm doing here is, once you have cooked it for like around 20 minutes, you can add in like a bit of a tomato puree. Probably I would say like 3 or 4 tablespoons. And then you can also add in the cashew nut and almond paste. Probably you have to soak this cashew nuts and almonds overnight and make a thick paste out of it. This adds to the richness of the gravy. So, and then keep simmering them. And again, after 10 minutes, add some kasuri methi right at the end. So mutton handi is ready. Enjoy it with parathas and pulao. Follow my YouTube channel for